in this life in hope for you. Open your heart, receive from Him. Christ is calling you, brother, receive your hope. Christ is calling you, sister, receive your life. Preaching Christ, the hope of glory.
Many men are suffering many things. Many women are suffering many things. If you're a man, you shall not suffer what men suffer. If you're a woman, you shall not suffer the sufferings of women. There are so many things that young people suffer. But I want to say to young people here, you shall not suffer what your friends suffer. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I said in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Brother, receive your hope.
We welcome each one of us to the house of the Lord this morning. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. I hope each one of us is excited that we are once again in the house of the Lord this morning. Tell your neighbor, I'm glad to be in the house of the Lord this morning. In case you're here for the first time, you may be interested to know that our theme for the month of July is dry bones must live again. Dry bones must live again. It is essentially a theme on restoration and revival. Because God is a God of revival. He told us in Joel chapter 2 and verse number 25, he says, I shall restore to you the years that the locusts have eaten. The cankerworms, the caterpillars, the palmerworms, my great army that I sent among you. It says, I shall restore. God is a restorer. God is a restorer. And I don't know what has gone missing in your life, or that which was damaged, that which was taken away from you. God is restoring it back to you this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. I said in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Somebody shout with me, restoration. And our anchor scripture has been Ezekiel 37 verses 1 to 14. Ezekiel 37 verses 1 to 14. And I want to read verses 1 to 7 very quickly here. The Bible says in verse number 1, the hand of the Lord came upon me and brought me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the midst of the valley, and it was full of bones. Then he caused me to pass by them all around, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and indeed they were very dry, very dry. And he said to me, son of man, can these bones live? So I answered, O Lord, you know. Verse number 4, again he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, oh, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, surely I will cause breath to enter into you and you shall live. And I'll put sinews on you, verse number 6, and bring flesh upon you, cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live. Then you shall know that I am the Lord. Now, verse number 7, I want us to read, all of us together, verse number 7, 1, 2, go. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a noise, and suddenly a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to bone. Praise the name of Jesus. He says, so I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I did it, there was a noise, and suddenly a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to bone. I want to share with us from verse number 7 on a message that I've entitled, Stop the Noise. Stop the noise. Somebody tell your neighbor, stop the noise. Say it again, stop the noise. Hallelujah. Many times when you set out to accomplish something, to believe God for something, noise is going to rise. I'm talking about voices of discouragement that will come from the camp of the enemy. Obstacles that will rise to hinder you from experiencing that which you believe God for. The Bible says that when Ezekiel began to prophesy so that the bones should come back to life, there was a what? A noise. There was a noise. Of course, the noise of that verse number 7 was a rattling sound because the bones had to come back together. But the noise that I'm referring to in my presentation here has to do with the noise of the enemy, the voices of discouragement, the voices of fear and intimidation, the voices of darkness that seek to hinder the child of God from experiencing that which God has ordained for him or her. And whether you like it or not, every time you make up your mind to believe God, the enemy is going to rise against you. But this morning, we carry grace to shut him up. Amen. I said we carry grace this morning to shut up the noise of the enemy. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I said in the mighty name of Jesus. Every time you make efforts to believe God for a change in your life, for a breakthrough in your life, for translation and progress in your life, the enemy will be provoked to anger. The enemy will be provoked to anger and will try to rise against you and make some noise against you. The idea is that you should give up on God. You should give up on his promises. You should give up on that which you are believing God for. And this morning, God says, stop the noise. Stop the noise. The noise must cease. I said, the noise must cease. Now, Isaiah talks of the voice of the strangers in Isaiah 25 and verse number 5. I want us to look at this. Isaiah 25 and verse number 5. Somebody is leaving this meeting today totally revived in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I say totally revived in the name of Jesus. Amen. Somebody shout with me, Lord, I'm ready for revival. Lord, the Bible says in verse number 5 of Isaiah 25, you will reduce the noise of the aliens as heat in a dry place, as heat in the shadow of a cloud. The song of the terrible ones will be diminished. It says you shall drown the voice of the enemy. There is a voice. There is a noise that is coming from the stranger, from the alien, from the enemies. The voice that says you shall not make it. The voice that says it shall never work. The voice that says you can never go far. The voice that says the way you are sick, you are not going to finish this year. Every such decent voice and the discouraging voice from the pits of hell must be diminished this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. I said in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, in case you didn't know, you came to have that noise of the enemy stopped in your life. That noise must what? Stop. Tell your neighbor, the noise must stop. Hallelujah. When Moses heard from God to go back to the land of Egypt and deliver the people from the hands of Pharaoh, when Moses showed up before Pharaoh, God says, "Let my people go." Pharaoh said, "Shut up. Who is the Lord? I don't know the Lord. Therefore, I shall not let the people go." He made some noise. Pharaoh made noise against God's agenda for the people. But God humbled him. God humbled Pharaoh. And Pharaoh's noise came to a complete cessation. When God hammered his firstborn, and the firstborn of every family in Egypt, including the firstborns of animals, they were hammered, but later on he rose up again to make some further noise. But God drowned him in the Red Sea. Whoever has been pursuing you to make noise against your life, against your marriage, against your business, against your prospects in life, I command them to drown in the name of Jesus. I said, I command them to drown in the name of Jesus. Tell your neighbor, stop the noise. Yes, the noise must come to a stop. The noise must come to an end. The noise must come to an end. The noise must come to an end. The Bible says, talking about Jairus. Jairus went to Jesus, Mark chapter 5, verses 24 to 25. He went to Jesus. He knelt before him. He said, "Please come to my house and lay your hand on my daughter, for she's at the point of death." But as Jesus was on his way to the house of Jairus, you know the story, and I want us to look at it. Mark chapter 5, Mark chapter 5, Mark chapter 5. The noise must stop. The noise must come to an end. The enemy must shut up. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. You remember when Daniel was cast into that den of lions, what happened? The angel of the Lord came to shut the mouth of the lions so that they don't make noise against Daniel, that they should not swallow. That is why they could not swallow Daniel, because their mouth were shut. I see God shut up the mouth of your enemies in the name of Jesus. You shall never be a victim of the scourge of the tongue and the enemy's voice in the name of Jesus Christ. Please, you believe that? Can I hear you shout a better amen? Mark chapter 5, I want us to look at this. The Bible says in verse number 35, it says in Mark chapter 5, now if you look at verse number 24, the Bible says, so Jesus went with him. Let's start from verse number 23 and verse 21. Now when Jesus had crossed over again by boat to the other side, a great multitude gathered to him, and he was by the sea. And behold, one of the rulers of the synagogue came, Jairus by name. And when he saw him, he fell at his feet and began and begged him earnestly, saying, "My little daughter lies at the point of death. Come and lay your hands on her, that she may be what? Healed, and she will live." So Jesus went with him, and a great multitude followed him and thronged him. By the time you read verse number 35, the story is different. The Bible says, while he was still speaking, some came from the ruler of the synagogue's house, who said, "Your daughter is dead. Why trouble the teacher any further? Why trouble the teacher any further?" Have you seen it? They came from whose house? They came from his house. The Bible says some, not everyone, but some. That is what the enemy does. Every time you set out to believe God for something big, you want to make a difference, the enemy appoints some to work against you. They appoint some. He appoints some to fight against you, to confuse you, to discourage you, to shut you up, to frustrate your efforts. But I decree that contingent of some that was specially packaged and mandated by the devil to work against you catches fire now in the name of Jesus. Yes. I said that contingent catches fire right now in the name of Jesus. Yes.
You remember in the experience of Elijah that the king kept sending a contingent of 50 people. 50 people to attack Elijah. 50 people. 2 Kings chapter 1. 50 people. Now, every time they came, fire. 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 Now, that particular contingent that has been specially packaged and anointed by the devil to frustrate the will of God in your life this year, I command it to catch fire now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, if you don't set them ablaze, the enemy will set you ablaze. If you don't fire your enemies, the enemies will fire you. So you must fire them before they fire you. I decree, let them catch fire. I said, let them catch fire. I said, let them catch fire. Tell your neighbor, I came for battle this morning. My enemies must catch fire. Praise the name of Jesus. The Bible says some. Those that have been working against you, it's not like it is not the whole team, it's just some that has been picked out because they have studied your movements, how your marriage is, how your finances are, how your plans for the year are, and then he has packaged some experts that can expertly frustrate you. I decree their frustration is frustrated. I said their frustration is frustrated. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every noise, God, sickness, marital struggle, financial struggle, stagnation in business, in your life, I command it to stop in the name of Jesus. I said I command it to stop in the name of Jesus. I command it to stop in the name of Jesus. I said, I command that noise to stop in the name of Jesus. It says, you shall reduce the voice of the aliens. You shall drown the voice of the strangers. You shall drown the voice of the strangers. In Nehemiah chapter 2, if you read verses 1 to 10, now hear me. You remember that Nehemiah, you know, went back to Jerusalem to help the people. And when he submitted the letters to the governors, in verse number 10 of Nehemiah chapter 2, the Bible says, when Tobiah and Sanballat heard that somebody had come to Jerusalem to improve the welfare of the people, they got angry. Every time you set out to improve the welfare of your life, the welfare of your marriage, your business, your career, the enemy will rise up with some noise. The enemy will rise up to frustrate you. And I decree over you this morning that whatever the enemy was doing in your life is now frustrated. I said it is now frustrated. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. What the enemy said you're not going to have, you shall have it in abundance. I said you shall have it in abundance. Where the enemy said you're not going to cross, I see you cross in grand style. Somebody shout with me, I've already crossed. Say it louder, I have already crossed. Because some of you, the enemy in his calendar, he had wanted to kill you last year, but he couldn't kill you. Now because he could not kill you last year, he cannot kill you this year. In the name of Jesus Christ, tell your neighbor, I'm unkillable. Praise the name of Jesus. The disease they wanted to put on you, I put it on them and their children. In the mighty name of Jesus, the accident they wanted you to have, let them have it on your behalf. I said, let them have it on your behalf. In the mighty name of Jesus, lift your right hand and shout, stop the noise. Say it again, stop the noise. I like it because in that verse number 7, we don't see, that is Ezekiel 37, verse number 7. We don't see Ezekiel running away from the noise. Tell your neighbor, don't run away. Because some of you have been amazed. Every time you say, I decree, change in my life, change in my, that is when you see the opposite of change. Breakthrough in my finances. That is when you see the opposite of financial breakthrough in your life. That is the noise I'm talking about. The noise must come to an end. I said the noise must come to an end. I said the noise must come to an end. I want us to read that Nehemiah chapter 2 and verse number 10 because
It is really important. Nehemiah chapter 2 and verse number 10. Now hear me. When Sanballat the Horonite and Tobiah the Ammonite official heard of it, they were deeply disturbed that a man had come to seek the well-being of the children of Israel. They were deeply what? Disturbed. Every time the enemy sees you shoulder to shoulder with your husband, with your wife, in marital peace, he gets deeply what? Disturbed. So he begins to strategize on how he can destabilize your marriage. Every effort of the enemy to destabilize your life, I decree it is frustrated in the name of Jesus. It shall never prevail against you in the name of Jesus. Lift your right hand and shout, I'm ready for it. Say it again, I'm ready for it. They were deeply disturbed. Deeply what? Disturbed. In the workplace, some people will be deeply disturbed when they see you progressing in career. When they see you driving a nice car. When they see you enjoying good health. They say, nah, we thought that he was going to die so that we can take up his position. Deeply what? Disturbed. Disturbed. Deeply. I don't know who is deeply disturbed. There are deep disturbance who never cease in their life. In the mighty name of Jesus. I said in the mighty name of Jesus. I said in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Let's look at blind Bartimaeus. Blind Bartimaeus set out to believe Jesus for the restoration of his sight. And we are in the month of restoration. Restoration never comes without some battles. That is why you're hearing such a message. This is a battle message. Hallelujah. It is a spiritual warfare message. The noise must what? Stop. The noise must stop. The noise must stop. The noise must what? Stop. In your marriage, in your career, in your health, in every facet of your life, the noise must come to an end. You may not like the message, but God says the noise must what? Stop. The noise must stop. Mark chapter 10, verses 46 to 52. The man set out for a change of level, restoration. Dry bones must live again. I cannot continue like this. My restoration, must come. Restoration of sight must happen. Jesus asked him, he said, what do you want, boy? He said, I want to receive back my sight. That is what dry bones must live again is all about. Restoration of dignity, restoration of favor, restoration of progress in your life. You cannot continue in stagnation. You are destined for progression, not stagnation. Restoration must happen. Change must happen. Connectivity must take place in your life. You must be connected to the blessing that God has ordained for you. And this man set out to experience just that in his life. When he heard that Jesus was passing by, he cried out to the master. And the Bible says some people came to shut him up. They came to make another noise, a contrary noise. The man made the noise of prayer to Jesus. He noised his petition to Jesus. Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. And then the enemies came. People came around him. They said, hey, shut up. That's not the kind of noise we make here. Shut up. I suspect that they didn't want the man to see. Do you know there are people like that? They don't want you to have what they have. They rejoice when they see you struggle with life. They don't want change in your marriage. They don't want change in your finances. They don't want you to live in a good house and drive a good car like them. Man is selfish. Man doesn't want you to have what he has. So when you have it, they begin to ask, are you going to manage this car? How are you managing? This car is beyond you. Why drive a double cab? Are you going to manage it? How are you managing your Jeep? How are you managing your Jeep? The devil is a liar. I command him to scatter now. I said I command him to scatter right now.
in the name of Jesus Christ. I said, in the name of Jesus. They said, shut up. Son of David, have mercy on me. On me what? On you. Shut up. But I like Bartimaeus. He didn't mind them. The more they stopped him, to him it was as if they are saying, cry more. Sir, I should cry more. He didn't hear it the way they were saying it. He held it the other way around. Every time the devil presents his notion to you, hear it the other way around. When he preaches that it cannot work, just know it that it is about to work. It is about to work. It is about to work. It is about what? To work. You are leaving this house with a testimony. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I said, in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody lift your right hand and shout, the noise must stop. Say it again, the noise must stop. Say it louder, the noise must stop.
Calling you, sister, receive.